The U.S. Senate will be back in session this morning in hopes of advancing a COVID-19 stimulus package. No progress was made yesterday as that package failed for a second time. Congressman French Hill joins us live now from D.C. to discuss exactly what's going on. Thanks so much for joining us this morning.
You bet. Thanks for having me.
All right, Congressman, what can we expect from today on the Senate floor? Do you think there will actually be a vote that happens today?
There could be a vote today, but I think it's more likely the vote will be early in the morning. I think that's very disappointing because they had such a productive week last week working on a bipartisan basis to put the ways and means together to help our small businesses and all businesses affected by this virus. Because if you want to keep workers employed, those businesses have to have the liquidity resources here in the short run to help people stay on the payroll and not go on to unemployment insurance.
Yeah, and so that package, you know, it's failed already twice. Many Americans feel like this is kind of a partisan politics being played from both sides of the aisle. What exactly are you doing to make sure that this isn't just partisan politics? Because there are a lot of people losing jobs, a lot of people without income right now, a lot of uncertainty right now.
Well, in the House, we passed very quickly on a bipartisan basis the stimulus, public health money that's necessary for all of our hospitals and researchers to fight the vaccine. We passed money for childcare for people who are in quarantine and their kids are home from school. We ensured that insurance companies don't have copays for treatments for coronavirus. And then we also passed things to increase the unemployment insurance and increase the Medicaid match in the states to get more money to the states. So all that's now done. The one part that's not done, phase three, is this part to keep businesses functioning so that people are not laid off. And last week, I spent all week working on that bill with my Democratic and Republican colleagues and got a number of changes. I spent 30 years in business. So writing those provisions is something I worked very hard on last week, and the bill that's in the Senate is a good, balanced, bipartisan bill. I'm just disappointed they can't get it voted on and get it to President Trump's desk and to the House.
Yeah. What do you want Arkansans to know who are worried about the future?
Well, I think we need to just get through this next few weeks of the virus. It's going to be a better future on the other side of this sweeping pandemic. That's number one, is that America's a great country. It'll be a healthy country. It'll be an economically prosperous country in the months ahead. But we just have to band together as neighbors and friends and citizens to beat this virus here in the next few weeks.
All right. Well, thank you so much for joining us this morning from Washington, D.C.